Thank you so much for having me here. TriMania, it's just an absolute honor to have been invited. And I know you all came for those USAT awards, but I appreciate you staying and listening to me. I do. Really, it's such an honor. And the thought that I'm even here right now and that you want to listen to me speak is a dream come true. And my goal here is to inspire all of you to know that no matter what your dreams are in life or in this sport, that your dreams can come true. And part of my story that I want to share with you is the fact that all the things that I dreamt of from a kid to where I am now seemed absolutely impossible to me and probably to the people around me. But I wanted it bad enough. I had this incredible burning passion to want to do whatever I had to do to make my dreams come true. And somehow I'm standing here today. So thank you so much for coming. I'm very bad at multitasking, but I'm going to try and show you some pictures along the way because it's kind of a great story. Excuse me for this. I'm really not good on the computer. Okay, so here it comes. Now, first of all, this is kind of what I'm all about. Surround yourself with the dreamers. And that's me, the one in the yellow dress that was very young at that age. There I am again in my little, I don't know if you can pick me out. I'm the nerd in all these pictures. This is going too fast. So anyways, in my early life, there were a couple years where I didn't say a word. I was a terrified little kid. Grew up pretty insecure, didn't have a lot of confidence. Somehow I was able to work my way to getting into a great college. I went to Brown University, ended up playing field hockey, ice hockey, and lacrosse, and did okay, but still insecure, shy, dorky. I can show you a couple dorky pictures here. There I am. I don't know if you can see. I'm kind of a little bit of a heifer there on the right-hand side. So basically a real dork. Anyhow, my start into triathlon, I moved to Worcester, Massachusetts, right after college, and I worked for the most incredible place, the YMCA. Really didn't have a clue. Yeah, the YMCA rocks. Didn't have a clue what I wanted to do with my life. But I met this amazing woman named Lynn Oskey, who some of you may know. She was a triathlete here in this area. And one day she said, "Hey Siri, come watch me do this triathlon." And I'm like, "Oh yeah, that sounds great." And I had no idea what a triathlon was. I thought it could be anything from a tennis type game to whatever, but I wanted to pretend I was cool. So I just showed up. And I remembered watching these people, all different shapes, sizes, ages, out there, you know, pushing themselves to the limit, but enjoying every moment. And in that instant, I thought, this is what I want to do. And I had a couple problems, though. I didn't know how to swim. I'd never ridden a bike. I only knew how to play field hockey, ice hockey, and lacrosse. But nothing was going to stop me from giving this a try. So Lynn Oskey kind of took me under her wing and decided to teach me about the sport. And I'm forever grateful to her. I haven't kept in touch with her, but I wish she was here to say that if it weren't for her, I wouldn't be standing here today. Now, my wonderful mom, who has always been my greatest supporter, she was who I learned to swim from. And I was 23 years old at this time. And my mom has such gorgeous hair that when she swims, she's like a swan, like this, so that she doesn't get her hair wet. And that's all I knew. Now, I'm going to start telling you these stories, and you're going to think I'm making this up, because it's almost beyond comprehensible that I could be this dorky, whatever you want to call it. Anyhow, so Lynn says, "Let's get to the pool, show me what you can do." And of course, I get in there, and I'm like frantically, like swanning it to the other side. And she takes one look and says, "Oh my God, okay, well, we've got some work to do here." It felt like forever to get to the other side of the pool. and it was at Bally's Sports and Fitness. The pool was like 15 yards long. Barely made it. But I got out that first day. She was exasperated, and I'm just like, yes, I love this. I want to be the best in the world at this. And she just kind of looked at me like, oh, boy. So anyways, I got into it. She taught me the ropes. I tried to, you know, get involved. I decided I wanted to go do my first race. And my mom at the time was living out in Colorado. And I said to her, I want to fly out to Colorado. I don't know anyone there. I want to do my first race where no one's going to know who I am or what I'm doing. So I head out to Colorado. We go to the grocery store, and I say to my mom, okay, you know, it's an 800-meter swim, it's a 12-mile bike, and a 3-mile run. I need to carbo load, okay? Now I just bought this beautiful new race suit. Awesome. We go to the grocery store. I'm talking pasta and garlic bread and cookies and all kinds of stuff because I had no idea what carbo load means. I just thought, good, I get to pig out. And my mom looked at this and was like, are you sure that, you know, this, you need to eat this much? And I'm like, yeah, I'm so full, but I've got to finish off this whole bag of pasta, so keep it coming. So I carbo load, which, just so you all know, you can have faith, I'm better about nutrition now, and I won't recommend this to anyone. Anyways, I show up the next morning in my beautiful new suit, but unfortunately, my belly was like this. And I could barely fit in my suit as I was like walking up to the table, which was my next big dilemma. Because they said, okay, you know, we got to, the swim is in a pool. And they said, we've got to figure out what wave you're in. So, you know, what's your 100 meter split? And I'm thinking, what? Like 100 meter split? I can't do a split. They're like, no, what is your, and the lines forming behind me with all these athletes that are eager to get started, and I'm just like, well, I don't understand, so 100 meters, and they're like, you know, is it 115, 120, 125, 130, and I'm like, everyone's like, come on, hurry up, so I'm like, 115, I don't know, 115, so they're like, okay, you're in wave one, great. So I step up to the thing, and I don't know if you guys have done pool races, but like you're in a lane with like five other people that were my 115 group. And I'm oblivious because I'm just stoked to be there. But I step up to the line all bloated, and here's the front line right here, and I'm like, I'm staying right in front because I want to have a good start. Behind me, and I don't think I even looked or noticed, but apparently just those, like, you know, like the big swimmers with like the big chests and the big muscles popping, and there was I in my bloated bathing suit up in the front. Gun goes off, I go jumping in. All I remember is just complete, like, washing machine. And it was like the worst thing in my life. I was just so panicked, but I just kept swimming and swimming. I lost all my technique, just fell out the window. I was back to the swan completely. You know, you fall back into your bad habits. So back into the swan, and absolutely horrible. But the best thing was that I was only 100 in, and everyone else had gotten out because they'd finished. So I had the lane to myself for the rest of the swim. That was awesome. Then I calmed down, and I get out. My beautiful, wonderful mom had my spandex pants all ready for me. So I jump out of the pool. You know, if you know the rules, you're not allowed to get any outside help. But she's standing there with my spandex. Siri, over here! Over here! I'm stretched out, and I'm trying to put my leg in, and it's all wet, falling all over the place. Guys come running over. You're not allowed to get outside assistance. So my mom's all upset because she can't get my pants on. So I've got one leg down, one up. Grab my mountain bike, which I've rented. Oh my God, it was like the hardest, hilliest course of my life. Actually, it wasn't, though, it was completely flat. But I was stuck in one gear, but I'm loving it. Like, I'm having the time of my life. My mom's almost in tears because she's been yelled at. And probably because her daughter looks like a freak. And one leg up, one leg down, crotch down here. Anyways, I get off the bike, and I'm so stoked to run. Because I love running. I've run up and down a field my whole life. And I take off Like, a ball is right in front of the goal all the way down there, and I need to go pick it up and throw it in the cage. So I sprint off, like, 100 meters fast as I can. And I have to stop because I'm hyperventilating and trying to grab my breath. Once I get my breath, I do it again. I sprint. By the 20th sprint, I'm like this, dry heaving, looking just absolutely exhausted. And there were people, now I don't remember this at the time, but everybody was just like, oh my God. And of course, the leg's still down here, and the other one here, and the crotch here, and the who knows. Running, I'm doing sprints the whole way for 5K. And vomiting or semi-vomiting. Anyway, so everybody's just like, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Anyways, I finish, greatest moment of my life to that point. And my mom's got all the stuff in the car already. And I'm like, what are you doing? The award ceremony is on. And she looks at me like, I don't think you're going to be winning an award today. I think I was the last to cross the line. And I was devastated. I'm like, well, I'm going to wait because I think that, you know, there's a chance. Optimist, always optimistic. So we wait for like 3 hours. Of course, there's no award for me. And we leave. So we go home. Don't worry, I'm not going to talk for 10 hours on this one race. But get home that night. And it was when I went to sleep that night. And suddenly my heart starts racing and I start seeing these images of all the things I didn't notice when I was racing, but I must have seen flashbacks of people like, oh my God, how embarrassing, look at that girl. Oh my God, she is just horrible. Oh my God, what is she doing out here? Oh, oh God, she's terrible. All these things suddenly came to me and I just burst into tears. I was devastated, burst into tears, went down to my mom's room, and I was bawling, and she said, I know, honey, I know, maybe it's just not the sport for you. And I said, no, Mom, I want this more than anything in the whole wide world. I love it, and I'm going to prove all these people wrong, and I'm going to prove to myself, most importantly, that I can do this, because I want it more than I've ever wanted anything before. So, of course, my amazing mom was like, okay, I'll give you 2 years. Put all your time and energy into making this happen, and if in 2 years you're not going anywhere, then we'll go get a different kind of job.